This is the Death Row and Executions Channel. Here is your host, Paco Rivera.
Welcome to the Death Row and Executions Channel. My name is Paco Rivera. You can also follow me on Facebook for updates and more Death Row news. There will be a link to my Facebook in the description below. You can also check out my other channel here on YouTube called The Maximum Sentence, where I cover recent crimes and convictions. There will be a link for that as well. There are two executions scheduled for October 17th of this year. One is mass murderer Derek Dearman in Alabama, and the other is Robert Roberson in Texas, the case that I will be discussing today. 22 years ago, on January 31st of the year 2002, Robert Roberson, a single father, arrived at the emergency room of Palestine Regional Medical Center in Palestine, Texas, with his two-year-old daughter, Nikki Curtis, who had suffered severe trauma to her head. Nikki, while on life support, was then transferred to Dallas Children's Hospital in Dallas, where she died a short time later. Doctors notified police because they had suspected that the injuries found on little Nikki Curtis appear intentionally inflicted, and her death did not seem to occur from natural causes. By the way, I'm not sure why Robert Roberson's daughter has a different last name than his, but I didn't think it was relevant enough to research the reason. Also, while Roberson was acting as a single father, he did have a girlfriend living with him. However, she was also in the hospital in Palestine, Texas, at the time, recovering from recent surgery that she had. This is a case that has made a lot of news in the media, and the Innocence Project has taken on the case because of widespread dispute that a crime actually occurred. Roberson and his lawyers have insisted over the past 20 years that Roberson has been on death row that little Nikki died from a combination of accidental and natural causes, because she was also diagnosed with severe pneumonia at the time that she was brought to the hospital. This case also tells of medical staff at the hospital being highly suspicious of Robert Roberson because he had seemed completely unconcerned, didn't show any concern or worry about his daughter's condition when he brought her to the hospital. He was completely calm. However, it was later learned that Robert Roberson is also autistic, and that would be the natural reaction of an autistic person, regardless of the extremely traumatic situation that was currently taking place in his life. Doctors at the hospital and a medical examiner that later examined the body of little Nikki determined that she died from shaken baby syndrome. Robert Roberson was arrested the following day after the emergency room visit. When Roberson was questioned, he informed the detectives that his daughter had been sick for about the past week and that he had taken her to the doctor's office twice. She was also prescribed medication, which, by the way, his lawyers have reminded everyone, are medications that today are no longer prescribed to children. But in 2002, they were. Robert Roberson, during questioning, had also said that Nikki had fallen out of her bed the night before he took her to the hospital. He said that he had rushed over to pick up the child and comfort her before tucking her back in bed when it appeared to him that she was not seriously injured by the fall. The following morning, however, he found her unresponsive. The medical examiner also concluded from CAT scans that the child had severe brain swelling, which was inconsistent with bumping her head on the floor from a low fall from a bed. In one report, it shows Absent a massive car accident, a child in Nikki's condition must have been violently shaken and possibly struck against a blunt surface. A child with no significant external signs of trauma would have the following internal symptoms: bleeding inside the head under the dura membrane, brain swelling, and retinal hemorrhages, bleeding in the eyes. Prosecutors trying this case have, in essence, claimed that a child with pneumonia, even taking incorrect medications, and a short fall from a bed, even if she bumped her head on the floor, would not exhibit these severe conditions. There really isn't a lot more that can be said about this case. A jury gave more credence to the prosecution, and Robert Roberson was found guilty and ultimately sentenced to death. He remains on death row until his scheduled execution on October 17th. This was a case where you either believe the scientific evidence presented by the prosecution that Nikki could not have died by accidental and natural causes because of the injuries shown in the medical exams, or you believe that the science is wrong. This is what we know about Nikki, who died at the age of 2. She was born to a homeless, drug-addicted prostitute in a hospital in October of the year 1999. That woman's name was Gwendolyn Michelle Bauman, which still doesn't explain where the name Curtis came from. Maybe who she thought was the father? Soon after Nikki's birth, the newborn was taken into custody by the state of Texas and later handed over to her maternal grandparents, the mother's parents, Larry and Verna Bauman. It was right before Nikki's second birthday that Robert Roberson came forward saying that he was the father. A DNA test, a paternity test, confirmed it, and he was granted custody. So he had Nikki a very short time before she died. As you can see here, even though the case files report the name as Nikki Curtis, it is her maternal side last name shown on her gravesite. Please remember to hit the subscribe button for more death row and upcoming execution stories so that you're alerted when the next one comes out. You can also follow me on Facebook for updates. There will be a link to my Facebook in the description below. I am Paco Rivera. Take care and bye for now.